13 boys dead?
Yeah. All of them with some guns. And I ain't scared. They kill one, I go take two. They kill two of mine, I go take three.
Yeah.
Yo, my life ain't a gun, but fuck. If you try to take me, I'll take you.
Gangs and gang violence have been very prevalent in several countries, both regionally and internationally. Street gangs are known to be one of the most active groups of people that partake in murders and killings. Many are puzzled, wondering if there will ever be an end to these gangs. Drive-by shootings, robberies, assaults, and homicides are recorded on the very long list of gang-related criminal activities. Not only the well-developed countries like the United States of America have an issue with gang violence, but also countries like Trinidad and Tobago, Venezuela, Guyana, Syria, and even Belize. The Caribbean is well on its way to be the home of many gang members. These people leave many terrified within various countries. Families have lost their mothers, fathers, and even their kids who are involved with these gangs. It is almost safe to say there is no end. Let's look at gang violence in Belize. Belize is an independent country located on the Caribbean coast of Central America, bordered by Mexico to the north, Guatemala to the south and west, and by the beautiful Caribbean Sea to the east. It is home to the dense jungles with monkeys, jaguars, forests, rivers, caves, and fish-rich reefs. It is a gem in the eyes of tourists. But what we don't see on the Belize brochure cover page is a high gang-related crime rate. But what contributes to the high gang violence?
The recent increase in teen murder and gang violence in Belize has become so notoriously prevalent that we can no longer turn a blind eye to it.
What is it?
This is the Mexican Kush.
Huh?
Yeah. We don't sell high Joe straight Kush.
Wow.
The Kush is expensive than the high Joe.
Like, how much is it a part of everything that's going on with them?
No, part of everything, because without the weed and thing, we can't eat.
Well, we have a lot of big guns in Belize. I've been shot by an AK.
Where'd they get you?
They caught me right here in my shoulder. You know, this one
right
here.
Yeah, yeah, right there,
you
yeah.
know, I get caught here.
Where were you actually when you got shot then?
I was trying to rob cocaine. I was trying to drop cocaine, you know.
One of the leading factors of gang violence in Belize is the increase in chronic vulnerability. Chronic vulnerability refers to the vulnerability of people who reside in the poorest of areas of the country. Poverty-stricken areas are described to be fertile terrain for violence to sprout.
You know, I went one day to San Pedro because the guys, they came in, the Colombian guys, they came across the
Colombians
San Pedro,
were coming yeah. in with drugs.
Yes,
right?
And they wanted fuel for order to get to Mexico, so they offered us drugs for fuel.
You were hitting these Colombian guys and they came in their boats. How much were you really making?
Well, I wasn't working with them. I just went to do a fuel run for them. They wanted fuel, but we don't want to give them fuel. We wanted their drugs. Right. We wanted money.
Well, how much would they offer you in terms of payment?
Like 2 kilos for maybe two jumps of fuel, you know?
2 kilos?
Yeah, for just 2 jumps of fuel.
That's a lot of cocaine.
Yeah, because they have tons. They have tons of cocaine. You know, they have big boats with a lot of drugs, you know. I see all of that, man. I want it all, but I just got 7 kilos, just, you know.
What happened to those guys?
They ended up running. I shot one of them in the belly.
All right.
Hey, Gay, tell them why you lose your job, man. You know why you lose your job? Tell them why you lose your job. Tell them why you lose your job. Because he was a dirty cop. He take away cocaine from guys, from bad guys like us, take away drugs, and he ended up taking it for himself and selling it to the street guys. We call him Eggy. You know, Eggy is a dirty cop.
Tell him
about the story of being a cop and a dirty fucking cop. That's what you should tell him.
Why did you leave the police force, sir?
Why did I leave the police force?
You can't answer the question. Why did you leave the police force? Eggy's clearly unwilling to incriminate himself on camera.
Within poor areas is where you find the movement of drugs and firearms Since it is a form of income, and where there are drugs, weapons must also be. People found selling counterfeit drugs or people who owe money to drug lords are often hunted down and killed by gang members. If they are unable to find you, they will target your loved ones, and sadly, children and teenagers are no exception. Gangs, especially structured ones, operate as a type of business. Drug use and access to guns have been an overlooked factor for the increase in crime and violence.
While there has in fact been a sustained law enforcement effort to crack down on drug-related activities countrywide, in Belize City, the trafficking and sale of marijuana, as well as its consumption, are at an all-time high.
Most of we business are illegally hustling, you understand me? Take risks. We take risks with we life. The risk we have is sell a weed, a lee quarter pound of weed if we try to put food pan for we table, and then we tired of that too, because you get harassment from the policeman every time. We know into the policeman and can harass you every time, those guys sell a lee weed to try to eat too.
Do you not worry that because of what you do that you could be killed?
God created me to live. I'm gonna live, and to tell you the truth, all the other youths in the world, I wouldn't want them to come like this. I know the way the world is running, and I know how we are going in my country, but come on, man. We can't get no sensible jobs, or minimum wage is a little bit of fucking money. How the fuck can we live? I, as a ghetto youth, right now would want to get out of this game. But I can't. Who will I turn to? My daughter is 3 years old. My son is 1 year old.
That's a responsibility, isn't it?
I gotta face that. Every day I come out, I think about my head getting shot open. I can't get out, man. This is my life. I was born here, I'm gonna die here.
Researchers have stated that murder booms occurred as drug transshipment increased, and that there is a connection between drugs and violence. Could it be that some, especially those already in gangs, turn to selling drugs and other illegal ways of making money? Unfortunately, Central America is right in the middle of drug trading between North and South America.
Mental health of gang-affiliated young people are significantly impacted, especially if they have been serving for years. The primary cause of both female and male youths joining gang groups are peer pressure, poverty, unschooled, or underlying issues at home.
You consider yourself a Crip?
Yeah, I'm a Crip.
What made you want to join?
It's just a habit, eh? I born around Lone Blue. So I was born around Red, and I was going to be Red, right? But eventually, just got to get a first kill. And if you're strong enough, then, you know.
You have to kill someone and then you're in?
Yeah. Just don't tell shit to the cops, right?
Gang members are more likely to suffer from a variety of mental illness, such as conduct disorder, antisocial personality disorder, anxiety, psychosis, and drug and alcohol addiction. Violence is ingrained in the culture of gang, and long-term exposure have been linked to mental health issues such as depression, behavioral disorders, and post-traumatic stress disorder, which is PTSD. The more risk factors that young people are exposed to, the more vulnerable they are to unfavorable consequences. Girls in particular, participating in gangs, are more likely to have mental health issues as a result of sexual and intimate relationship abuse.
The south side of Belize City is known for the formation of gangs and gang violence. Those communities are affected negatively as the years go by and the crime rates increase. Research indicates that many of those young men that join these gangs are seeking the feeling of belonging, identity, and to boost their self-esteem. Many of them are from single-parent households where the father is missing and the mother is busy trying to provide the necessity for them to survive, Due to this, majority of them look up to the men in these gangs as a role model. Because of the lack of supervision, many boys eventually join these gangs for a sense of power. Mothers are now living in fear for their children's life, and others in the community view their home as a prison because of the uprising of gangs.
The South Side is known to not have many financial resources, and some of the residents cannot afford what we would consider minimum living. Due to this, many of the young boys we see drop out of school to help bring in income to try and acquire the basic need in their home. These boys, majority of the time, is in high school or some even at primary school that we see eventually fall out. Teenagers who live in poor communities are unable to obtain the requisite education to find work, or simply do not choose to do so. Because they're unmotivated, some of them do their hardest to avoid acquiring an education or a scholarship to help them support their education. They'd rather find a quick method to get money, even if it means breaking the law. As a result, they regard working for gang members as their only source of work. Those who parents try for them may still fall into the trap of joining these gangs simply because of friends or even the connotation that comes behind being in a gang.
Gang violence has been a threat around the world and has brought about many adverse effects. It is far from being beneficial to anyone. Many lives have been lost due to gang violence, especially in Belize. However, people have the power to put an end to it. Many people are ignorant until it involves them, but by that time, it is too late. Bringing awareness can be a game changer. The best course of action is to find a stop for gangs to cease the violence.
If gang-affiliated youths are offered the right programs and opportunities, then they are given hope, which persuades them to not go into the direction of joining gangs, but instead branch out into society as the future of Belize. Creating a plan of action to have home visiting, nurturing programs, preschool projects, and school-based social and enthusiastic improvement projects can protect kids from the dangerous factors of joining a gang and poor emotional wellness, including parental stress, openness to violence, and conduct issues.